Yeah.
Money never sleeps, pal. Just made 800,000 Hong Kong gold. It's been wired to you.
Play with it. You done good, but you gotta keep doing good. I showed you how the game works. Now school's out.
Mr. Gecko, I'm there for you 110%.
No. You don't understand. I wanna be so...
Boom, baby. You don't understand. Today I teach you.
Surprised.
Astonish me, pal. New info. I don't care where or how you get it. Just get it.
Ah, oh, Jesus. I wish you could see this. Lights coming up. I've never seen a painting that captures the beauty of the ocean at a moment like this.
War. War on Wall Street. War on Bitcoin in the 1 minute chart. Risks. You must have risk. You know, I went super heavy and shorted Netflix stock. Okay, yesterday it went up $86. Now, I feel nothing. I'm going to show you my position. This is the game. The game of risk. Financial fluidity is the ability to take risk and not feel anything. Financial fluidity means that you have come back from defeat before, bigger, badder, and stronger than any other time. So yesterday, Netflix is pumping against my short positions. How did this happen? They sandbagged. You know what sandbag is? I'll tell you. After earnings, they have a conference call. And they give guidance, which is their expectations for the next quarter. The last quarter, they got hit so bad by subscriber loss, just like the quarter before, and they got tanked. So they sandbagged. In the conference call, instead, they expected last time them to have 8.1. This was in the previous conference call. This is where they tell you expectations, what they call guidance. Now you're gonna learn about sandbagging. 1 million subscribers, they got 6.1. The stock tanked. So this time Netflix gave guidance very low. Sandbag, okay, like 2 million subs. And they blew it away. Duh. Dumb people on Wall Street said, oh my God, this is awesome. Another trick they did. See, now nobody could see their books before earnings. Okay, that's when they make it public. But they are saying, for the first time, they actually showed a profit. No shit. Because for the first time in months, they have not made any movies. So of course their production value or costs have gone down. So of course it makes them look profitable. Now, options expire. You have a limited time to get out. So let me show you my account. True transparency. I kept winning and winning and winning and winning, and the day before earnings, I put it all back on black. I went from 168,000 to 354,000 in a short period of time, a matter of 2 weeks. Yesterday, my account looked like this. Instead of being up 91% and 94%, making 100 grand here, 100 grand there, 70 grand there, it went against me. My $354,000 turned into $17,000. Most people at this point sell. I am willing. This is the strength of all strengths. You must remember, the human brain is filled with emotions. I have no emotion. I am AI. Now yesterday, the market was up 257%. Okay? Now, today in the pre-market at 8 a.m., we're up again, but not as much. So when I look at my account, I'm not going to sell at the point of max pain, okay? When I am down at the most, I feel nothing. Instead, I wait for today. I wait for the excitement to die down. This is the highest Netflix has seen in a very long time. Do you think that people are not going to begin to take profits? So in the next few days, okay, I have a few more days here, a whole week. All I need is one down day. All I need is one down day for them to pull back. Here's where I stand before the market opens. Let me just tell you straight up, $15,000 compared to $300,000, I wipe my ass with $15,000. I would rather let this go to zero, okay, than close it and walk away with $15,000. I'd rather walk away with nothing. That is the eye of the champion. Now, there was no way for me to see that their production costs have gone down, okay, and that they were going to claim profitability. And I don't listen to conference calls and stuff. I don't have time. And I didn't know that they sandbagged. Sandbagging is giving a low guidance, which is easy to beat, so your stock goes up. It's unbelievable that it's even legal, but they get away with it. So that's what happened to Netflix. That's my story. That's The Big Short. The future remains to be told. And in true transparent, and it's not over. So back to Oracle versus Oracle, and by this time it's 10:29. Currency that nobody will ever show you. I will show you this. So let's refresh Netflix. Already in the pre-market, they're down $4. People should start taking profits. If the market was down, this would be even easier, but we will have a down day. We will have a down day, be it tomorrow or the next day, and I will wiggle my way out of these options. And if I have to lose the whole 300,000, I feel nothing. I am machine. It is one loss amongst many wins. So we're gonna save this. We're gonna screenshot where we are. When the market opens, I'll show you where we stand. AI trader, the options trader, the risk taker. The only way to get rich in life is to take massive risk. Most of you never achieved this because you have not been successful yet. First, you must make everything, and then you must lose it all. And through this process, you develop a fearlessness called financial fluidity that allows you to feel nothing. You become a machine. So this was the pre-market this morning, and I said the irrational exuberance will end, okay, and I just need to wait. I'm most likely going to lose my money, but not $300,000. And even if I did, I feel nothing. Let's see if Netflix, the market is open, 5 minutes. It is so important in any kind of trading that you learn to feel nothing. You must feel no connection to money in order to win. You must take risks. I could have done this many different ways. I could have straddled it. I could have used some strategies. I could have bought some calls and puts. I decided to go this way. See where they're at. People are taking profits. This is good. We're down $6 already. I was down hundreds of thousands, right? 350,000 or whatever it was when I was making all those kills is now 15,000. If I would have sold, but instead I stay and fight. All I need is one down day. I still have time. This is the highest that Netflix has been for a very long time. Look, now people trying to buy the dip. It's going up and down. And this will happen all day. As you can see, I am going to stay and get back as much of my money as possible. This is the options game. You either hit or you miss. Now, I went in very heavy on this. I could have done it many ways. This is what I chose to do. Okay, and now it's pumping up. That's fine. It's updating in real time. I don't care if I lose it all. I will stay and fight. So Netflix is bopping up and down. Of course, with a gain like that, people are going to take profits. So that's all I'm waiting for. So now the game becomes time. The options decay over time. So I have a limited amount of time for this to drop as much as possible or pull back for me to go ahead and exit my positions. This is so exciting, you have no idea. You can hear in my voice, I don't even flinch. This is my world where I come from. All we need is one bad down day, and it looks like, let's refresh. Wow, we're up 257 points. Is that accurate? That can't be accurate. Hold on. Yeah, it looks that way. Nope, down 30 points. All right. And some bad news, which is good. All right. And so we sit here. And this is how it goes. The mind of a trader. A real trader. All right. This is what hedge funds go through. This is how you get rich, by taking chances. So tune in tomorrow, and I will update my Netflix miss. I am so proud to be so transparent, whereas nobody else ever would. Win, lose, or draw, there's only one oracle. And this, my friends, is how you make money, okay? You take risks. I've lost before in options, and I've won massively. The movements can be massive if you get the earnings right, but they sandbagged us with a low outlook last time. Fake profitability. Why are they profitable? Because they haven't been making any movies. Duh. So everybody's all excited by this news. They don't know what to do. I sit and wait. So we went from 586 to 580. See, I don't sell into the peak of fear and fury. No. I have no emotions as a machine. I wait. I hunt. I stalk. So let's tune back in tomorrow and see what happens to the Oracle short. Now, at this point, I missed earnings. I expect to lose. It was a miss. It happens. I am the only one that would ever show you anything like this, because I'm a real trader. I have no emotions. I am a machine. So Netflix has gone from 586, 580, 576. Now they popped up to 580. Okay, it's just a matter of time. And I will continue. Subscribe. I will show you this. And I will show you my next targets. I am still core numbering Apple. Apple's moving up into earnings, which are a few days. I'm doing my core number. Okay, like I showed you on my Cash App in previous videos, where I've gotten out my entire investment and have totally free stock in Apple, okay, using core number strategy. So this is a little bit of a risky earnings play. Right now we got enthusiasm going into it. And Tesla has been dropping. There are major shorts against Tesla right now on Wall Street. Hedge funds are shorting the stock. This is a very, very scary stock, okay? Because this is emotionally driven. It's not driven by any fundamentals whatsoever. And so right now, Netflix is 579 at 10:52 a.m. And again, Apple's been unbelievable. I could tell you my Apple story. It's been amazing. But we'll see how this pans out, okay? And I'll make another episode tomorrow. If you like transparency, if you like honesty, okay? Tell me in the comments. And remember, I told you not to follow me, okay? I said you didn't even know how to trade options. This is my world. So, I think we should go out on a happy note.
Do the Miley Coke go. Coke.
Let me check this out.
Do the Miley Coke go. Coke. Let me check this out. go, coke.
Let me check this out.
Do the Miley coke go. Do the Miley coke. Do the Miley coke go. Do the Miley.
I love this fucking song.
Do the Miley coke.
Let me check this out. Let's check out Netflix tomorrow. Let's hit some more options.
Let me check this out.
Let's play the game, baby. Subscribe and watch the story unfold.
Let me check this out.
Boom.
Let me check this out.
It's time.
Let me check this out. Let me check this out. Let me check this out. Let me check this out.